Everyone, this is another tutorial of UART interfacing with N76E003. Basically, the UART is used over here using the timer 3 function. So the timer 3 is used for the generating baud rate at 9600. So the baud rate can be changed over here to 11,500 if it is set across the 9600 baud rate. So the timer can be initialized at any baud rate that is required for the applications, and the next line, that is the TI, that is set to the 1, is used for the printf function to used in the code. So if your code is using the printf function, make sure to make the TI to set a 1. And here is the code. The code is using over here, it's a while loop that is receiving the data from the keyboard. Whatever the switch it is pressed from 1 to 4, 1, 2, 3 or 4, it will display which switch is pressed. So if someone press the 1, it will display that 1 is pressed. So basically, using this application, the UART receive and transmit both function can be displayed. And if anything other than the 4 switch is pressed, it will display that error message with the wrong key pressed. So this is the full code that is shown over here. Other than this, there are some definition that is actually how the timer is working. Let's see what is in the timer function is used. Sorry for the camera. And here is the timer initial UART 0 timer 3 definition in the function that is available in the common.c. However, I need to mention one important thing, that is there is a error in the BSP package library. If anybody is using the BSP sample code for UART, make sure that the P07 input mode is set to a input mode, because it is not in the BSP package library. There is a error or bug that is set to a quasi mode. Basically, P0.7 is a receive pin, so it is an input pin, so it is needs to be set to a input mode for the perfect operation, but instead of that it was set to a quasi mode. Make sure to change it to the input mode for error free operation. It took me a lot of time to understand why the receive mode is not working, and found the bug in the code in BSP package library. Other than this, there is the SCON register that is setting the UART 0 model. There is the SMOD register also that is set for the double rate enabled. There are timer 3 control register and the UART 0 baud rate clock source to the timer 3. So the timer 3 is used for the clock source. And here is the TCON register, timer 3 control register, that is used to configure the timer 3 for this baud rate operation. Other than this, there is a timer 3 trigger and the printf function for the TI. So everything is available over here. And other than this, there are another function that is used, that is the receive data from the UART 0 and send data to the UART 0. By the receive data from the UART 0, we are just waiting for the RI flag, and the receive data is captured in a data variable called C, and after that the RI set to again 0 for receiving the next data, and it is returned by this function. And send data to the UART 0 is done in the same way but in reverse order. So basically it will set the TI to 0 and SBUF to the C, and it will wait and check whether it is the send to the UART or not using the while TI is equal to 0. So this is all the code. It is a very simple code, and let's compile it over here. So I have just compiled it, and it shows zero error and zero warning. So without any hassle, we can just flash it to the board, and it is already connected with the laptop. So I have just flashed it, and as we can see, here is the connection, hardware connection. I am using a USB to TTL converter that is using a CP2102 driver IC. So basically this UART module will be provide a serial output to the computer, and I am using a serial terminal using the TeraTerm. So basically here is the TeraTerm, and I am just using it. So as we can see, here is the COM3 port that is shown, that Silicon Labs CP2102 USB to UART bridge. I'm just pressing it to the OK. So this is the already set, and let's reset the module. So I have resetted and it is already printed hello circuit digest, press 1 or press 2, press 3 or press 4. So I am just pressing, sorry for the camera once again, I am pressing press 1. So basically this is showing the 1 is pressed, and if I press another switches 2, 3, 4 etc. So it will provide it. So this is all, and if I make anything press, just like I have pressed the 5. So it is showing that wrong key is pressed. So this is everything that is using the UART receive and transmit function over here. So everything is available, and how to configure it in the code section, document section, and the code section in the circuit digest. So have a nice day and check it out. Make sure to change the BSP package library for the input mode. Have a nice day. Bye bye.